Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Risk of Rain 2. Thank you, everybody, for your patience on the lack of Risk of Rain 2 content as I was waiting for the new patch to arrive, which dropped today, the 25th of June, 2019. Extra special shout-out to everyone who's been patiently awaiting for this as well, as those of you who've been liking and subscribing for the Risk of Rain 2 content. I really do appreciate it. We have ourselves a new survivor along with a new stage as well. So I've been trying to unlock the new survivor. I've only attempted it one time, and hopefully I'm able to get it done this time around. I am going to be playing on Drizzle, however, because there's a very specific reason why you want to be, well, you want to take it easy on this one. So, but again, I do want to say thank you to everybody first and foremost for those of you who've been enjoying and rewatching all the Risk of Rain 2 content. I know that the lack of content here has been kind of a little bit of a disappointment, but that is okay. So the first thing we're going to do here is show you exactly what it is that you need. So I found this out thanks to chat. Apparently there's a panel behind your fuel pod, and now you can extract this fuel array. So the idea is that to get the new, and I don't know what the new survivor is, I only know how to unlock him, but I haven't actually quite done it yet because I only attempted it once, but essentially you have to carry this thing all the way to the fourth level, and then something happens. I don't know what, because chat has not spoiled it for me. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to fight the first boss and then take the fuel array out. That way I'm guaranteed that we don't let it explode. Now, the stipulation for the fuel array is going to be essentially the if you drop below 50%, the fuel array explodes, and that's something I found out the hard way the first time around. So, yeah, it's going to be a little bit of a bummer to try to have to baby this thing all the way through, but with the Huntress, I have my supreme confidence in my ability to keep it safe. So we just cannot drop below 50% HP, and which means I'm going to be very, very cautious. Now, what is this? Is this a... Did they increase the... This isn't a large chest. I've never seen this type of chest before. 30, it should be only 25. Utility chest. Oh, you know what? It's a green chest, I guess, maybe? World War Stealth Kit, I'll take that. Thankfully, we'll only have to do this once for the unlock, I assume anyway. I probably should take that healing drone if the object is for us to stay above 50%. Now, we also have a pretty good reason to rush through the game on this run. It also allows me to see if we get the new level right away. Yeah, so that was a utility chest, which is completely different. For $5 more, you get a guaranteed green item, at least, which is pretty good. I'm just assuming that's what that was. Got a green here. It's going to be a hop-up feather. I like my hop-up feathers on my Huntress. And really, I don't think there's any shame in doing this on Drizzle. I don't see why you would want to subject yourself doing anything else, because it's so easy for the game to take you below 50%. Got a blind item over here. Hop-up feather, by the way, is going to give us a double jump. Gives us an additional jump, I should say, every time we're in the air. Let's see. What is that? That's a turtle. I gotta take it. It's a new item. The Topaz Brooch gained temporary barrier on kill. Hey, there you go. Hey, look at that. All right. I'm down with that. That'd be very good for the mercenary, that's for sure. We've already found a new item here. Lots of stuff down that way as well. You see Tough Love right there, or Tougher Times, I should say. $50 larger chest, which is not a utility chest. I guess the large chests have also always guaranteed greens as well, so I'm not exactly sure what that chest was. All right, so it's Tougher Times, Medkit, or War Banner, which I have... I mean, Tougher Times is the pick there, but obviously I'm gonna be going for the large chest first. And before Sedicta likes large chests. And we got ourselves Legion Seed, sure. Thank you. Take the small chest over here. And we get the bustling fungus. Not too keen on that, but I think that'd be it for this floor. Two caches here, which I will open real quick. I'm not going to play the Chant Shrine, of course. And I think we'll take tougher times, and that'll be it. Now, here's the hoping that I don't forget... Oh, there's still a chest here. Here's the hoping that I don't forget about the fuel array. Hey, we got tougher times anyway, so there we go. All right, second stack of tougher times in the bag. Let's go fight this boss. We'll turn around, go get the fuel array, and then that'd be it. So you can see down on the bottom left of the new barrier mechanic as well. That's pretty neat. It gives you a real real representation in real time of what the barrier's covering. So I like that a lot from the Topaz Breach. Brooch, I should say. Or brooch, depending on where you are from in the world. Wandering Vagrant. Again, super happy I decided not to pick up the fuel array. Now, the Huntress can get on top of the, she can get on top of the Wandering Vagrant, as you see right here. It's just a little bit harder for her to dodge the Supernova. Because you have to time it just right. And I don't really like doing that. Because the timing window is really, really tight on that, I would rather just line of sight it. Like this. This is much easier. There we go. All right, so 6 minute floor one. Yeah, I know we're on drizzle, I know. But hey, I only wanna have to do this once. We got a uke. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna wait for the teleporter to completely charge up, then I'll go back and get the power array. And then that's when we have to get real careful. I'm happy that we have a decent amount of defensive items that can help us mitigate the damage too. So we hopefully don't lose the power array, because I want to do this one and done. Gonna skedaddle on over here to our landing pod. I probably could go play the chant shrine. I might as well do it since it's right here. So there you do see the power array that's strapped to the back of the Huntress. And if you take too much damage, it will explode. But apparently it can kill you. It didn't kill me the first time, but I also didn't realize what was going on when it was exploding, so. That's funny, game. All right. So that was a huge waste of time and money. But if anyone was expecting or just wondering if Sinvicta Luck was not still alive and strong in Risk of Rain 2, there you go on that. All right, we're in the wetland aspect. So I'm not going to play this Shrine of Blood for obvious reasons. We cannot afford to do that. I hear wind now, too. What is that? There's a purple chest here. Some spooky things going on over here in this tree. I mean, I do kind of want to see what that purple chest is. Let's find the teleporter first. Bronze contraption. You need to be careful here. Okay, so as they attack, as a heat-seeking missile, Will-O-the-Wisp, which is probably what we're going to end up going for. It's going to go very nicely with our uke. I don't know if they actually did anything to nerf the stone golems. I hope they did, but they probably didn't. Alright, need 10 more bucks. Go from one stone golem to two, I guess. Now I'm trying to line of sight these stone golems because, again, we only have the 50% HP threshold to go for them, and then we lose the fuel array, which is not what I want. Alright, so I'm going to buy Will-O-the-Wisp here. I'll go back and go look at what that purple chest was, and then we'll go straight for the teleporter. We're really inclined to, or we're incentivized to go fast through here, just to get to the level four, just to get to rank four, level four, whatever you want to call it. Floor four. So I see that purple chest right there. Open up this one as well. Crowbar, okay. Crowbar, again, combined with Will-O-the-Wisp is very, very good. Does more damage on your first hit. And this gave us another hop-up feather. So I wonder if the purple chests will guarantee you a copy of one of the items you already have, maybe? That's sort of that's an uneducated guess there. The purple chest guarantees you a copy of something you've already picked up. That'd be kind of a neat mechanic. Okay, there's our teleporter. What's this? Ah, Healbot. Alright, let's go fight the boss here and just head on down to the next floor. Hopefully it's not the Wandering Vagrant. Alright, it's going to be the Queedlebean. Queedlebean shouldn't be too bad. Jaro's Band, nice. Man, I gotta say this, the Topaz Brooch is really useful in this respect. Giving us an overshield like this is pretty nice. So we get the red whip, which doesn't do much for us, but hey, it's movement speed out of combat. It's a kind of orange chest there that's not a legendary chest, excuse me. Man, look at our overshield, and it decays really slowly too. I wonder if the amount of stacks that you get of the Topaz Brooch, if that increases or decreases, it increases the decay time, or if it just gives you more shield per kill. We'll go check that out in the logbook, if I remember, of course, after this. Yeah, really good second floor, though. We got a lot of really good quality upgrades here. And shout out to the Topaz freaking Brooch. Giving us that overshield. It's pretty darn nice, I gotta say. Okay, so we did not get the new level here for the third world. I'm told that it was complete RNG, so, you know, with Synvictiluc being in play, who knows exactly how long it would take us before we finally get to see the new area. But hopefully, at least we can show you how to unlock the new character. You heard Red Whip kicking in there. I did see the sequencing shrine, which I don't care about. What is this? Ah. So this is a... We're not sure yet. I assume it's just a healing pack that just heals you back to full, maybe? We can't afford it yet, so I don't think it's going to give me a tooltip. There we go. There we go. Open chest healing. Yeah, this is the healing chest. Man, it feels good to be playing Risk of Rain 2 again. Don't care about the equipment barrel. You need to slow your roll there, Buffalo. You need to be careful of the imps, of course. Ourselves a regular chest here. What we got? Another crowbar. Very happy to see that. Okay, there's our teleporter. I'm almost tempted just to go in the teleporter right now. I mean, we have two crowbar. I should at least go check to see what's in the cave. If we can get more tougher times, that'd be nice. But at Risk of Rain 2, the more offense you have, the better. The faster you can kill things, the faster that you can be safe. Remember, kids, if you want true ultimate safety, just kill everything around you. Then they can't kill you. Another message here. Or not a message, but the Stealth War, Old War Stealth Kit. I did see that one vendor. Careful, do not shoot the barrels. Do not shoot the barrels. Let's not make the same mistakes of old now. Hey, another Topaz Brooch, okay. What is this? It's a regular chest. Colonel Bobble, eh. Not really my idea of a good time. I don't like it. There we go. Okay, let's go fight this portal here, and hopefully we'll be done with the unlock. I don't know where the thing that I'm supposed to use the fuel array for is, but hopefully it's painfully obvious. I'm a little bit bummed that we didn't get to see the new area. But again, with RNG being a factor, it's not that all surprising. Get down the wisps here. One more chest, might as well. I definitely am loving the new tracks as well. It's the same track, but they added more layers to it. I really like that. Top notch work. All right, here we go. Oh, good. Because Lord knows when you need to make sure that you don't go underneath a certain threshold of HP. The Clay Dune Strider is there to ruin everything. It'll take a little bit of concentration here. Thank God for this overshield. Those are going to do its whirly bird. We still have the overshield, which is good. Alright, Clay Dune Strider's down. Got a Clay Pigeon, which is fine. Or Wax Quail, I mean. So many Wisps. Get out of there. We did it. All right, we made it. So we started in a place I've never seen before in the Abyssal. I mean, I've seen this place, but now we have to look for something that we can put the fuel ray into. What's this? Whoa. That was weird. It did a little matrix. Vroom. Oh, hey, they actually put chests in here now. Good for them. And a drone. Yeah, so we have these weird statues now. These things, these hallways actually spawn enemies now, which is something different as well. Here's the exit. Okay, we probably don't need the HP chest. Right, there's a challenge shrine. Nothing immediately sticks out here. Large chest here, which I will take. I just want to, right now, the only thing I'm looking for right now is to find wherever we need to do, wherever we need to put the fuel array. Because the longer that we hold on to it, the higher the chances that we're going to lose it. And I don't want to come all this way for nothing. Get a higher vantage point here. Yeah, we'll open this chest. Hopefully, I assume that it's not going to... Oh, attack speed is going to be... Oh, you follow me up here? Okay. Apparently the Elder Lemurians will follow you now up here. Yep. I still have a little bit of the over barrier. All right, down he goes. Okay. Let's get it. Now that we've got a high vantage point here. Bunch of large chests there. I cannot rely too much on the Topaz Brooch. Movement speed upgrade. I'm happy to have that. Oh, what is this? What is this? This might be it. That looks new, whatever the heck that is. All I gotta do is beat two prawns contraptions. Okay. Is this it? Repair one fuel array. There we go. Power plant. Repair the rogue robot and escape. The fuel, okay. So there we go. There's the new, this is the new character, the new survivor. It is a It is a flower. It is a mechanical flower, apparently. Okay, but hey, we did it in one shot. Happy about that. So I think that I'll finish off this run here. I'll finish off this run. I'm not gonna play this whole run all the way through because it's kind of late when I'm recording this. But I will at least do one level of the new Survivor. Legendary chest is still here. It's pretty cheap as well. Actually, very cheap. Why is it so cheap? So good. So that's how you do it. Again, I would... Oh, you know why? It's because we're on Drizzle. That's why. That's how I would recommend it. Recommend doing it would be on Drizzle for sure. Don't pick up the fuel array until after you're done with the first boss. And then just be careful all the way through. All right, so I'm gonna actually purposely kill myself here because I want to get a run in with the new character. Got my lunar coin. Kill me! They can't see me. So what? The first time in forever that I want you guys to hit me, and you guys just can't find me now. There we go. Try playing on Drizzle for an easier mode. Okay, so we unlock power. Power plant. The survivor is now unlocked. Its name is Power Plant because it's a flower. I get it. Power Plant. Okay, taking a look at Rex, the power plant. Certain attacks weaken, reducing speed, armor, and damage. Directive, inject. Fire 3 syringes for 3 times 80% damage. The last syringe weakens and heals for 30% damage dealt. Seed barrage, costs 15% of your current health. Launch a mortar into the sky for 450% damage. Directive, disperse. Fire a sonic boom that pushes and weakens all enemies. Hit pushes you backwards if you are airborne. Tangling Growth. Costs 25% of your current health. Fire a flower that roots that does 200% damage. Heals for every target hit. So he kind of reminds me of Nidus from Warframe. Now let me take a look at the Bronze Brooch real quickly here to see what the multiple stacks does. Was that a common item? It is a common item. Wow. The Topaz Brooch, not Bronze Brooch. Sorry. So it gain a temporary barrier on health on kill for 20 health. It goes up to plus 20 per stack. Wow. So you go up to 40 if you have 2. Well, hot dang, son. We'll do the first level here of the new Survivor just to see how it is, and then we'll wrap it up for this video here. And we'll play on normal right now just because, again, this is literally the first time I've ever played as the power plant, as Rex. Let's take a look at him. He's literally a flower that has a gun. Oh my god. Okay, so it's a triple attack. His sprint is burrowing into the ground. Okay. Okay. Let's see what his secondary ability is. Okay, so that costs part of Rex's HP. Oh, he can loot while underground as well. That attack reminds me of Kog'Maw from League of Legends. Right, let's see what his travel ability is. Oh, that's the knockback. Okay. And his ultimate ability. Oh, wow. Okay, so you can spam his secondary attack like crazy. Got Got the knockback there. So how much does it push you back? How much does it push you back if you use his knockback in the air? Pretty significantly. Dude, I like that. I like how it just falls through the ground. Wow, that does a lot of damage. The range is pretty impressive as well. How long is this range? It could go all the way out there? Are you kidding me? Wow. And we just got Leech Seed, too. That's going to be even better. So this is like a little HP mine that will suck everything up. Again, it really is like a combination of Kog'Maw and Nidus from Warframe. May still die here though. I gotta remember that my secondary ability costs a lot of HP. Hey, we got Topaz Brooch. Okay, so you want to set them up with the right click. With the secondary knockback. Okay, and his ultimate is directional, and it is it can be fired, so that's good. And can you imagine Rex with a bunch of attack speed? He's gonna be a fun character to play. Alright, let's go, before we end the video, let me just summon the boss, let's just see how well Rex can do. I love that he just jumps and then falls through the world. What an interesting design for a character. Here we go. Stone Titan, you're gonna need a lot of help for this one, buddy. So this is just constantly feeding me HP here. I'm just gonna sit here and just tank the beam from the Stone Titan. There we go, get the snipe dunk with the mortar. Yeah, and that actually, his ultimate feeds you a lot of HP very, very quickly. That's impressive. That really is impressive. I really like that mortar shot, too. Yeah, this is going to be a fun character to play, for sure, and to learn. I can't wait to see some of the synergies. Can you imagine with, like, an attack speed build plus, like, the rejuvenation rack for Rex? That's going to be crazy, man. What an interesting character. Shout out to the devs again. But I'm going to wrap it up here, everyone. Thank you, everybody, for the support. And hopefully you're encouraged and happy about the return of Risk of Rain 2 content. Definitely the next couple of videos that you see here on the channel will be involving Rex, the brand new character here. So, like I said, let me know what your favorite ability is of Rex so far. Have you played him? Have you unlocked him yet? What's your favorite synergies? Let me know in the comments down below. Check out our subreddit as well. And thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.